Oh, hi, Tech Rabbit here. I'm going to work on assembling the 3D printer. I'm going to do the Y-axis part up until the Y-axis carriage. That'll be separated into a separate episode. So let's get into it. So here we are, the Y-axis assembly. And I'm going to have to experiment. I also have a little mini cam, so we'll see. It's the best way to show things and operate. I have to start somewhere. So anyway, the first task is to see what we need. There are basic tools and those we have over here in the box. And then we need the basic parts, which is actually the main frame and the aluminium extrusion parts and then the screws to put them together. So let's see if we can find those. Oh. I'm assuming this is where the actual frame is going to be. And probably print bed and stuff soon. This is just the steel sheet, and that's an actual print bed thing. Heated bed, I suppose. PS2 and heated bed, I don't know why it says both. Not cold to look at that, so we can just separate it out. And here's the Y carriage. I don't need that yet. Pack that out. Just packing. And here's the frame. Oh, that's quite interesting. So, where are that? Said something about the Prusa logo should be in the front. Yes, here. So basically, this is the way around. It should be lifted up like that. Now I think we should experiment with the mini cam. Wait a second. That was the one I was thinking. We have a little mini cam where we can move around. And then I'm going to actually have different heights and stuff. Oh, we'll see if this is going to be useful. So, I'm just training up. First time I'm actually using this console. Okay, and then what do we need? We need extrusion switch. So we are in this Y-axis. Box. Okay. So it comes with the end plates, they're not needed, right? End plates out. The extrusion should be here. That's okay. Oh, there's two. Okay, there we go. Sorry, I just thought it. So, anyway, two short ones, two long ones. First, we have this whole box of screws and nuts and stuff, which is made for the Y axis. And there we need to first separate out those screws, which is M5 times 16 screws. It's a very weird way of writing it on the command. M5X16R. I don't know why they wrote it like that. So, go ahead and separate those screws out. Okay, now with the parts. So, we have the two long extruders, we have the frame, and the screws you needed, they come from. Oh, I have to switch to them. Mini cam view make more sense. So they come from this bag. And you can identify the screws by looking at the diagram there. So I collected the screws in here. 16 of them. If you want to identify the screw, then you just put it on top of that. And then basically, it should look the same. At the same dimensions as in the picture. Okay, and this one. And you should have the Prusa thing up there. According to the instructions. You need to take the longer ones, and then they're going to go here. They don't seem to be rather threaded, or does one have to screw them up? No, I have to sit. See how easily this goes. Wonder if it would be good to have a mini cam. So I'll come up like this. They must be threaded. Support this. Oh, they are threaded. Oh, nice. Thank you, Prusa. So we just start them up.
How are you supposed to do the frame on a nice flat, hard surface? So one doesn't tighten them completely at the first phase. Just tightens it just enough for the first thing. The screws pull them out. Could use a electric screwdriver and stuff. The thing is, I want to take it easy with this. It is aluminium parts, and you can use this. Battery driven screwdrivers or ones that actually have the hammering effect, then one might actually end up ruining parts. Trying to get it in the pitch. Well, these are actually quite easy to screw in. It's very nice. Very easy to assemble. They weren't threaded. So we use the holes to the second picture. And I should be using the correct holes as the inside ones. Yeah, the correct holes in the second picture. Use the M5 screws to the frame. Tighten the screws around just slightly. Now tighten the screws fully on the diagonal basis. Cross tighten. This one. So should be crack proof. Let's put the logo on this side. Almost extrude. It's actually hard to get a full profile picture. See the Prusa logo here. Almost the long feet.
Okay, and then it's to do the shorter ones, which is basically the same deal. So we're going the other side.
Screwing up the focusing on this. Poor camera. Doesn't know what it needs to focus. I haven't set. I've got out of focus and the poor thing doesn't know what to focus on. Yeah, but if we go to Medica instead. Just for this part. Can't trick the camera to refocus without taking away all the focus. Change to my own tools and come with faster.
Well, we're getting there. Same tightening trick as on the other sides. One takes it like that one, and then that one, and then that one. So far, so good. What's next? Go back to that one. You see, now it focuses. Switch between the different cameras and get the best possible pitch. Okay, so long extrusion should be on the side where we have the Prusa logo, and that's up here. There. And they should be closer together, and then the short ones should be on the outside here. And they should be further away. Okay, so that's done. And now we need to put in the front plate and rear plate and PSU holders, no power supply holders. These. Thank you. I thought I counted out 16 screws for my friend. Ah, I have too many screws in my box. Right, now we have here. Now we need to have another 16. So, I need a bit more screws. So, that's the rest of the screws. And then what we need to do is obviously going to be 4 screws per side of the plate, I would assume. It's the same tightening pattern, so one puts them in lightly and then tightens them up. I will screw them in, because I already showed how to screw these ones in, so we'll use some video magic and jump over this part. Okay, now we need to... this expert doing this. Come on, give me the picture back, please. Thank you. Start from here. Okay, now we should look as to what type of power supply do we have. Do we have the old one or the new one? So, here's the Delta PSU package. Have a black one, then according to the instructions we should insert the holders in a specific location. That's these two. And then we need to turn this around like that. Let's see if we can sort of. Next thing. Okay, then it's just to put the longer on there. It's just 8 screws, so I'll get that done. So, it's the end plate on. Let's see what's next up. Before you proceed, now that was the flat surface, so yeah, I had it on. I got flat surface. I think that's good enough. Then, mounting and vibration feet. Those could be installed now or later. Haven't got any gap recovering this. Let's see if I put it like that. So, we have this one here. I'll take the mini cam directly, I think. So, God, black on black is so difficult. But here's the group. So, we can insert it. And then this is like form like that. So you put it in the groove and then you turn it and then you position it. So I think it's supposed to go on the end there. At least that's what it looks like in the pitch, even if it's a bit hard to see. But I'll assume they should be positioned at the ends. And then there are four of them. Same trick here. Anti-vibration feet in place. You'll have to do it at the end. Okay. Y-axis smooth rods holders. So I'm actually going to have to find because it's not. Same bag. So, let's see. So I've got the focus back. We need to like hack away this stuff in this original bag. Because this hasn't got those. And then find where are those being kept. So we need to unpack this. This is the printed part. It's the same kind of that box or bag label. I'm going to have to empty that into a similar box that I had for the other parts.